this, I'd want to introduce my final speaker of the day, Arshin. Arshin is an engineer who's very fond of poetry and reading. I would like an evaluator G1 to read out his speech objectives.
Thank you, Timur Joth. A very good morning to everybody on. My speaker, Arshin, will be delivering her second speech under Level 2 of the part Dynamic Leadership, Understanding Your Communication Style. The purpose of this project is for the member to learn about different communication styles and identify her primary style. The purpose of this speech is for the member to share the impact of her style on others. Timer, please note the timing is 5 to 7 minutes. Arshin, all the very best.
Arshin, conversations, Arshin.
A very good morning to all present. 25th June, 2018. I get a mail in my inbox. Welcome aboard our team. I'm excited and happy to have you on board. You have been selected for employment because the characteristics you exhibited were in line with the attributes that we look for in our employees. No. That I'm concerned and that I expect your best each day. Also know that my door is open at all times for any sort of feedback. Your success and continued growth is as much your responsibility as it is mine. Thank you for joining our team. We were sitting in Pune at this time, and it was our first ever induction for my first ever job. I was sitting with a close group of 5 to 6 people, fresh out of college graduates. Perplexed, bemused, confused, all sorts of questions coming in my mind. What is professional communication supposed to be? What is networking? What is email etiquette? What is the difference between formal and informal communication? But my journey to understanding and developing on my communication style was already destined and was being spearheaded by a very able man, my first boss. Over the course of the next 1 year, I understood and realized that his was a direct communication style. He never really shirked away from giving feedback, positive or negative. And that sometimes depressed us and frustrated us. But then the next day, we came back stronger and with better ideas. But he also had a mix of initiative and supporting communication, where he made us reach the point where he wanted us to come to. But the only thing was that he was based out of Singapore and we were based out of Mumbai. I was a little apprehensive how this virtual collaboration communication was supposed to happen. But it went very well. And 4 months into the organization, we had something called the coaching conversation. In this, they sit you in the same room as your boss. You discuss feedback for each other and you tell us the highs and lows of your journey up until now. He was supposed to fly in from Singapore all the way to Mumbai, and we were very scared. This was my first ever review, and he was going to tell me what sort of leader or communicator I was. I enter the room, and he's smiling, and he gestures me to sit. I sit in front, and he tells me, Arshin, I've heard Mumbai is treating you quite well. And I was thrown off guard. I was expecting a badgering of questions, discussion of projects, what is going well, what is not going well. But he eased me into the conversation. He made me comfortable. And then he went on at length from 10 to 15 minutes about the praise and the appreciation that the senior management was showering me with for my tenacity. And this was the direct communication part of the conversation. The second part was the initiative and supporting one, where he made me reach the point where he wanted me to develop some leadership and personality traits, but he did not spoon feed this to me. I came to this point and it all went very well. And what I realized was that we might have one significant communication style that we ascribe to, but there are situations and there are communication styles. We need to understand and gauge the extent and the intensity of the situation to understand whether you need a direct sort of communication here or whether you want to help, support, encourage, motivate people to come to that point. Now, I'll give you an example of a classic communication gap, and let's see what takeaways we have from this. So this was a family of two, Don Bradley and Mrs. Bradley. and Don Bradley comes home after a very tiring day at work. Mrs. Bradley goes running after him and throws her arms around his neck. "I'm a month overdue. I'm expecting a baby. I think we're pregnant. But let's not tell anyone till the doctor confirms the news, okay?" And then they sit down and they were having dinner. And they received this phone call. It was from the electricity department. "Am I speaking to Mrs. Bradley or Mr. Bradley?" "Yes, you're speaking to Mrs. Bradley." "Ma'am, you're a month overdue." "I'm a month overdue? How do you know that?" "Ma'am, because we have it in our files." "You have it in your files? How do you even measure that?" "Ma'am, because we have a system to measure that." "You have a system to measure who is overdue and who is not? How dare you?" "Ma'am, calm down. It's a part of my responsibility. I have to do this." And she bangs the phone. She goes running to her husband and tells him aggressively what all happened with her. And obviously he's in a fit of rage. He goes rushing to the electricity office, bangs his hand on the table, and in front is the electricity officer. "How dare you tell my wife that she's a month overdue? How dare you?" Sir, calm down, sir. Calm down. "You just need to pay us and everything will be over." "I need to pay you? And what if I don't?" "Sir, then we'll have to cut you off." "And what is my wife supposed to do in that case?" "Sir, she's supposed to use a candle, maybe." And that's it. The communication ends. So I want you to write in the chat box, what is your key takeaway? What was missing in this communication? What was missing in this conversation? Context, the context was missing, the keyword was missing. Okay, so my two key takeaways, overdue to pay the bill, yes. My key takeaways from this were two. Be assertive, don't be aggressive. And use direct communication, fill the gaps, and then leave it to the other person. When I want to put across a point, I need to be direct. And my primary leadership, my primary communication style on the TI website was a direct communicator. But then, at other times, when the other person knows what he has to do, I don't need to be aggressive. I can put my point and then I can make them come to that point. And I've done that all my life. I have been direct, but I also have been encouraging, motivating, supporting, and initiative taking when I want them to realize that there is something that needs improvement and that there is something that they need to work on. I might not be the best communicator, but if you want to be a conversationalist, if you want to be a leader, I suggest you to gauge the situation and apply a specific communication style according to that situation. Don't think this is my primary communication style. Think about the situation. Thank you, and over to you.
So we'll start with the best prepared speaker. The best prepared speaker for today is Arshin. Can we please spotlight Arshin quickly so we can take... Arshin, one moment. Hold that beautiful smile. We need to take a screenshot. Hold on.
Guys.
Next,